Today I'm going to review the Sony TA-FA5ES. This is how you write it, yeah. And with the tuner, the Sony ST-SA5ES, yeah. This is the volume knob, muting, and a source direct, yeah. But nowhere in this amp I could discover the speaker A or speaker B switch. And okay, I have this remote control, this original remote control. I thought, okay, maybe it is on the remote control. But as you can see also on the remote control, there's nothing here where you can switch between speaker A or speaker B. And that's a very big mistake from Sony. And that's why I think this amp, yeah, also the 707, even if it is 1 year older than this one, it's more beautiful because of the two wooden side panels. And even if the 707 didn't have those wooden side panels, it was still more beautiful. And when you are looking for one of the latest Sony ES models, I would advise to stay away from the FA5ES, and I believe the FA7ES have the same thing with those speakers. Why, if you make four speaking connections in the back, why in God's name you only can play them all together? And that's very strange, because I can play all my speakers together because I have four home speakers. I will blow up this amplifier when I will play my four ohm speakers on and on. According to the information I have, this amplifier doesn't play 2 ohm. So if you play 4 ohm speakers together, you get 2 ohm. And so that's a bad thing. Bad thing from this amplifier. And I certainly understand why this amplifier isn't, well, it's cheaper than the 707. So the sound is okay. The sound is about the same as the 707. Nothing wrong with the sound, yeah. I also think it's not beautiful. It's not a beautiful amplifier. It is a beautiful amplifier, but not as beautiful as the 707. Just watch my other video I made from that beautiful 707. And well, I didn't have a tuner with that amplifier, and this one have, so I think, well, this is a very interesting tuner, very good tuner. And well, it's just a pity, because now I have to disconnect the complete thing and to hook these quadras again back to my Akai, because that Akai have a speaker A B connection. I mean, or maybe I will use another amp, I'm not sure, because I have to make these videos quick, because somebody will pick these speakers up tomorrow. So, and I have to make my video fast. Anyway, this Sony, yeah, it's from 1995, 1996, and the specs are okay, yeah. It is 17.5 kilogram, and I'm not sure if it also came with wooden side panels. I didn't see them. Yeah, I know the 707 I had came with wooden side panels, but this one didn't. I don't think they came with the wooden side panels, and they made them in black and gold. And of course, this color is much more attractive than that black color. And well, I see sometimes prices, yeah. I have this thing for sale for 2 weeks now, and believe me, I can't get a higher price as, well, 300 euro, I don't even have a bid from 300 for the amplifier. So I have a bid from 275, so I will lose money. I lose money on this deal. I thought I made a good deal, I thought it's just a normal price, 600 euros for a setup, a Sony ES setup, but I will lose about, well, I'm not sure, maybe 200 euro. But that's the thing with this stuff. Do your homework before you go buy something, because if you don't like the thing, if you buy the thing, you come home and you don't like it, then you discover that the money you paid is way too much and it will be impossible to sell it for the same amount. And I don't often make that mistake, but sometimes I make this mistake, and this time I make a very big mistake. I was just greedy because it looks so beautiful. And well, the guy told me he wanted to play it in his garage. Yeah, he wanted to buy another Sonos setup in his house and play this thing in his garage. And I bought the mirror speakers from him, beautiful speakers. And I thought, okay, I can pay easily $600 for this thing. And I put the money on the table. And in the end, the guy, it was not the money, because he was sure not to sell it. But his woman told him, well, sell this this set to these guys. And so I bought the set, and I thought, okay, this set I will keep for myself, beautiful set. But in the end, I thought, well, the Akai sounds better. The Akai is more ugly. Yeah, the Akai AM93 black. But yeah, it sounds better. So this will be my last Sony ES. I had now four. Yeah, I made a review from the Sony ES630 ESD. Yeah, with the DAC, the Sony 700 ES, the 707 ES, and this will be my last Sony ES, because I discovered that my Akai is better. So that Akai is the one to be beaten, and I don't think there is any Sony ES, also the 808, what can beat this Akai. I'm sure the Akai sounds better than the Sony 808 ES. So here ends my hunt for Sony ES. This is my last, really. Even if I can find a bargain, a very cheap one, for let's say I can buy the 808 for €200, for example, I will not buy it, because, well, my hunt is finished. I am, well, not disappointed in the sound. The sound is still very good, yeah. And for the looks, well, the looks is just beautiful. But you can't compare the looks from this one with the 707. The 707 is the better one. If you buy a Sony ES, try the 707 or the 808, because those ones have a normal selector switch, yeah, for the speaker A or B or AB together. And the 5ES and the 7ES, I believe, I'm not sure, but I believe the 7ES, the same series, don't have that. And well, that's very cheap from Sony. Unbelievable they make that big mistake, because it is very stupid. You make four connections in the back, but you don't make in front a selector A or B. Stupid. I don't understand this big mistake. I think they did it to save some cost, some building cost. And I can understand you want to spend money, but not on an AB selector switch. That's the most stupid thing you can do. Yeah. And okay, how much more do a selector switch cost? A extra selector switch with the, well, it's not only the selector switch, of course, but €20 more maximum. And that's what they save with this stupid on and off speakers. Well, it is just stupid. Speakers on and off. Why you need speakers on and off? Yeah, I need A and B. Yeah, or A B together. Okay. Forget that big mistake. And I now understand why these amps are not that popular as the previous mentioned 707. So that's said about this big mistake. As you can see, I will test the Sony STS-A5ES tuner. Beautiful tuner. The thing didn't came with a remote control. This is the remote control for the complete unit. Yeah, and as you can see, it also have a tuner, so you can manage the tuner, I believe, through this remote control. I'm not sure. Didn't use the thing. It works. Look, watch this. Yeah, it works, but I will not test the remote control, didn't try it out, just the volume up and down, and no time to learn the thing. This tuner have 10 presets, yes, 1 till 10, and A, B or C, so 30 together, and this is how it works. I just did it automatically, listen to this. And you heard the music now over my Magnat 07 speakers, okay? Everything is on flat. That's a big mistake. Anyway, this is how it sounds on tuner, and it's a beautiful tuner. I saw these tuners on the market in the Netherlands. One guy asked 300 and I think 40 euros for the only this tuner, and the guy is crazy because nobody will ask 340 euro or pay 340 euro for a tuner like this, even if it is a very good tuner. Well, I'm not sure how much I will sell this tuner. I will be glad when I can sell it for 100, maximum 125, and the amplifier, well, I will be very happy when I can sell it for 300 euro. And, well, I make a big mistake. Anyway, this is how it sounds on my MP3 player. I put it on, let me see, an aux. Pay no mind to the past. New love would last every night. Something right wouldn't buy.
For all the
Beautiful sound, really beautiful. Well, in fact, I love this sound, you know, until I discovered this Akai AM93. But this sound is really a fantastic sound. And, well, I can advise everybody, yeah, who just want a beautiful looking set, and most Sony ES, this one is the most ugly one, and also the first one, the black 700 ES, I didn't like that one also. And but all Sony ES sounds very, very good. They are very good sounding amplifiers, and every piece, so the tuner, the CD player, even the MIDI disc, if you have this in the setup, they will be qualitative, very good pieces. But when you buy a Sony ES, forget this one. Forget this one, because, well, only if you are sure you will never play more as one pair of speakers, it doesn't mind, you can buy this one. Yeah, if you are sure you will never spin more than one pair of speakers, yeah, like a lot of people do, yeah, it doesn't matter, because you only connect one pair of speakers and, well, the thing will play your speakers beautiful. But if you have plan, yeah, to connect two pairs of speakers, I don't know for what reasons, yeah, maybe a bedroom setup or a kitchen setup, yes, with this, you drive with this amplifier, then you have a problem. You have a big problem. And well, I don't like amplifiers with mistakes. And this is like a stamp, yeah. These stamps, they print it and they make it the other way around, so it was a misprint. And these stamps are worth, well, many more times the normal value of that stamp, yeah. But in this case, they built the whole series with this big mistake. One of those stupid, yeah, I think it was a manager, of course, a manager who thought, well, let's save some money, yeah, and let's forget the speaker A or B switch. And that's a very big stupid mistake. So the guy probably wasn't a music lover or an audio lover, because how could you make this big mistake? I just discovered this myself just now, because I didn't understand why this Sony's ES is so much cheaper than the 707 on the second hand market. This one is a year younger, and according to, well, top reviewers, top testers, this thing sounds even better, because it's a better development. And, well, I'm not sure, I think they sound just the same. Yeah, beautiful, just beautiful sound. But, yeah, I will not keep this thing, only because of this, yeah. I think it's a big mistake they made. Anyway, if you owe a F5ES or a FE7ES, the amp is still good, yeah, only probably you only spin one pair of speakers, then there's nothing wrong. Nothing wrong with it if you only spin one pair of speakers on it. But as soon you need a amplifier to spin two pairs of speakers separate, then this amp is very bad and very wrong. And it's just a little extra investment to place that switch. But yeah, I'm not sure why they left it out, and think it is very stupid, very, very stupid. And, well, the thing is, it is mint. I always check it here. If you want to see if something is mint, you go with your finger like this. You don't feel any scratch, then the thing is good as mint. Most scratches start on top. You can always feel it. You can always feel it in this corner, yeah. The tuner isn't mint. The tuner have a scratch, little scratch. You can see it here, little scratch, yeah, here, yeah, little scratch, and little thing here. But It is S99% mint. Beautiful tuner. Beautiful, beautiful tuner. I only don't understand all these. Well, the only thing I did was place some tuners in it, you know, in the memory. But I don't understand this program of set on. Yeah, I don't understand. Well, the thing of RDS. Yes, you can read it here. RDS. Yeah. That's very nice. My Akai tuner doesn't have RDS, and I'm not sure how it works. Yeah, I am. I didn't put much time in it. I only wanted to hear how the thing sounds, and the thing sounds perfect. The tuner sounds just perfect. It's a very good tuner, and well, it's only a pity. This thing is a pity, and well, it's a pity. That it isn't as beautiful as the 707. The 707 have a good switch for the speakers, and it is more beautiful. So if you buy a Sony ES, yeah, and you see on the market this thing, and you see, okay, the price is okay. Yeah? I think the value of this thing is about $275, $350, and only the amplifier, I mean. I don't talk about the tuner, I talk about the amplifier now. And it will be hard to get 350, I think. Yeah, I see some guys advertise this thing for 595, only the amplifier. But those are the crazy guys, you know, the dreamers. And they will never get, well, it depends, it all depends where you live, not in the Netherlands. There are in the Netherlands some guys who think, who went on Hi-Fi Shark, who saw these high prices and think, okay, this is the price, so I will place the amplifier for this price. Well, nobody will pay more as €400 for this thing. You will be very happy guy when somebody pays €350, and I think you will also be very happy when somebody pays €300 for it. And, I hope I get that 300 and 100 for the tuner. I have 400. I sold the broken MIDI disc for €25. So then I have 425. So I only lose 175. But I think I think I can sell the tuner for 100. But I don't think I can sell the amplifier for 300. So keep it in mind, guys, if you want a Sony ES, better pay some extra money for the 707 or the 808. Well, the 808 is very expensive. Yeah, I would go for the 707. The 707 is the best option. Also, the 707, for me, inside looks much better. Yeah, this one only have two end filters, end caps. Yeah, and the 707 have four of them. And also that selector switch, that speaker selector switch, and also the complete looks with the wooden side panels. Well, only the looks is worth the extra €100, yeah, and it has more power. Although it is only 10 watts, it is more power, and the weight from the 707 is 21.5 in comparison with this thing, what only weighs 17.5 kilos. So they made some savings, because they saved 4 kilograms. So where is this 4 kilogram savings in? I'm not sure. Probably in the building quality, I'm not sure. But the sound is okay. So I can't say that this thing or the 707 sounds better. I think they are equal with sound. Yeah, beautiful sound. But yeah, if I were you and you was looking for a Sony ES, skip this one. Go for the 707, pay €100, €150 more, and take that 707, and you will not regret that choice. Yeah, and for the tuner, well, the tuner is a good tuner. Yeah, if you want this tuner as a separate tuner in your setup, this tuner will do very good, because the sound is just beautiful. Let me one more time.
Nacho Randy Martina en afgeschreven. Zijn politieagenten ingezet om de EK-film.
beautiful tuner, beautiful sounding tuner. And well, I will keep it with this information. I hope you like this review. Put those thumbs up if you did, and don't forget to subscribe on my channel. Okay, for now I say bye bye.